This video is going to walk you through what you need to know to set up course completion settings for your courses. Course completion is going to come in handy for both you and your students. Your students will be able to use course completion to quickly see if they completed a task or not. They will be able to see a percentage marking of how much of the course so far they completed, and they'll also see a checkbox or an in progress button if they need to complete the task yet. You as the teacher will see the same thing, so this could be a great tool to use if you're just trying to quickly get a sense for what students did or did not complete. Whenever we set course completion, we're going to go into the lesson folders themselves, and then we're going to mark the different items that need to be completed for that lesson. All right, so what this looks like is if I go into my course content folder, I'm going to go into Unit 1, and then I'm going to just start out for the purpose of this is just saying, all right, I'm going to say, all right, my lesson 1, 2, and 3 are the items that I need. So I'm going to first go into lesson 1. And then I'm going to set my completion settings. All right, we have our introduce pages set up so that they display in line. So the students, when they go into the lesson folder, will automatically see this. Therefore, the introduce sections do not need to be included in the course completion. All right, to start with the course completion settings for a lesson, just click on the options button on the top of your course and then set student completion. On the left side, you're going to see the button that says add requirement. All right. Essentially, we're going to add each of the items that are in our lesson. So for example, I'm going to say add requirement. It should grab the things in order as they show up below. So the first thing I see is activate. And then depending what your activate thing, the students either have to view it or you could set it that they have to submit something. So my only option is view it since it's just a page here. All right. Then I'm just going to keep going down the list. So first I had activate, now I'm going to click learn. And then once again, this is a page, so my students have to view the item. Essentially, I'm just going to keep scrolling down through my list. All right, next I have an attendance check-in. This gives me an option here. I'm going to just set it so that the students just have to make the submission. Once it triggers that they have a submission, they can move on. All right, and I'm going to just keep going through for all of the rest of the items in my lesson, and I'll just stop here for the purposes of this. I'm purposely unchecking this option that says requirements must be completed in order. We do not want to set this because we want to give the students the opportunity to complete the attendance check-ins so they're marked as present, even if they may have to go back to complete something else. Right, it'll be a headache and a nightmare for the students if they would get behind, but yet still have a way to monitor the attendance for them. So we are purposely not making the students complete these in order. All right, what I'm going to do then is I'm going to hit Save Changes. You're going to notice that as the teacher, you see a button here for the ones that I just set that say the students must view the item or they must make a submission. The students will see the same thing. All right, so what's kind of nice with this is it'll give you a sense of what the students did or did not do. The students will even see a check mark if they have it completed. So it kind of gives them a point if they do things spread out over a couple days, they can kind of pick up where they left off and they'll see exactly what they did before. Now that you have this set up, you see a student progress button. And then for example, I have a sample student in here. Since we just set this up, the student did not do anything, but I can see right now, all right, for this lesson, the student has a couple things they did not complete yet. If the student goes through and actually opens these things and makes the submissions, you'll see a little checkbox and it will update the percentage of what the student has completed. All right, so hopefully this will give you everything you need to know as the student completion. This will lead us into our next thing, which is going to be looking at making sure the due dates and everything line up. We had to do the student completion first because whenever you set student completion, it will reset the due dates. So we're trying to prevent you from having to do double work.